And we're back. Alright. That went quick. That went real quick. Yeah. Yeah. Alright. So. Next steps. This is coming along. Setup. I know, right? They're so short. Oh. Well, I mean, that's why I try to take a break every hour. So 5 minutes is not... breaks it up a little bit better. But yeah. Get up, stretch your legs sort of thing. Paper? And a marker for their bottom for. Okay, we'll say this. After the group has created their characters, let's do this. That's fine. Place a sheet in the center of the table. Draw one entrance on each side. Say each edge. Everyone roll a die. Highest goes first. Okay. Cool. Basic setup. Good to go. Yeah, you said, yeah. So this is going to be rounds. We're going to change, we're going to rewrite most of this because this is where it got confusing. Each round is broken up into this knot. You open a new window. I realize now let's say steps. Two steps. Colon thing, mapping phase, mapping and characters. I think I need a new word for character. Oh, I know. Mapping and exploration. That's the deal. That makes more sense. This information is kind of unnecessary. On it, it's not you. But exploration. At the start, each round. The active player. God. During each step, all the players, during each step, every player will get a turn. First, starts with wondering now about turn order. Would it be better to have the same player go first every time? Or would it make more sense to transfer the first player every turn? I think the latter is a better, is more accurate, better. That being said, how do you determine who the next first, like, how do you determine who goes first in the next round? Is it the player to the right of the, like a clockwise or counterclockwise person? Or is it you re-roll highest die again? Yeah, those are the two I think. I think player to the right makes sense. But yeah, the one thing that that means is that you need... Maybe not. Maybe not. Oh, that's insane. Let's do it like this.
start it off. Have everyone roll a die. High Swiss ones. Starts with map. The first player starts by rolling 4 dice per player. This is the dice pool for this round. Yeah, for this round. Step. There we go. That's better. For this step, okay. Four dice. That seems so high. I'd say two dice. Yeah, let's say two dice per player. That makes sense. I don't know. I think it's one of those things that I would really benefit from playtesting. Okay. Active player picks a die from the dice. They consult the type of room tables. Pick. Picks a die, selects a die from the dice pool. Okay. This is worded hard. Writing rules is hard, or writing how to do things is hard, which is why technical writers get paid so much money. Consult the type of
table and select die from the dice pool corresponding I do that when I'm thinking. Bad habit. Corresponding to the value they've selected? Does that make any sense? God. God. Blank phases. Rolling. Rolling and draw. Whatever. The global map contains all the revealed information that is available to the group. This should be. This should be earlier on. Trying to make this present information in a readable way so that people can understand what you're doing at each sort of step. Oh yeah, okay, this makes perfect sense. This is the way I should do it. But what I need to do is I need to expand a little bit on what you're going to be doing with the maps in general. So before I get to the how you play and use your map, I need to just kind of briefly explain what's important about map making and how the maps will work. So I'm going to put the global map section in here. There's a part about legends, but that should come later. I realize right now that in the setup, I didn't explain what the pieces of paper are for or anything like that. So that's
something that should be in there. Yeah, I should do like a brief breakdown of the materials that you're given so that people know what they're for. A personal map, legends, tips and tricks is fine. Though that might be something I cut easily, like earlier, that might be something I cut fairly easily. I'm gonna remove the from, I like it. Characters. I'm wondering if characters should be formatting wise, I'm not liking this three dice, the way that this is formatted, so I'm gonna write that down to change that too. Though I wonder if characters should be included in the setup section of how I'll play the game, or whether characters should be a separate. I'll probably just leave it. Characters, HP, come back to that. That's formatting issues. How to play. Excellent. Setup. Mapping. Should be one on. Continuing. Probably. Global map is. I say this is not making, because I like that better. So I gotta expand on a few of the sections. That example of play is garbage, oh my god. Starting to come together. 8:30. There's a term for this. It is up passage. Oh, sequence of play. Active player starts with their map making phase, map making step. Then the player
Yeah, okay, so this will be left. Clockwise would be to your left. Counterclockwise would be to your right. Yeah. Okay. We're good. We're good. I got there. Don't worry. We got there. I think that's the only one where it matters. Okay, cool. Alright, fix all that. Fix all of that. The Old Ruins is a game about maps. Map making and cartography. Throughout the course of the game, players will explore the ruins and make their map to give to the king for their reward. All available to the group sits in the center of the table and contains all the revealed information. Really? Because my drop frames is so low. Like, so low. Like, check this out. This is the most insane thing I've ever seen when it comes to streaming. like, I very, very unlikely, like, am so doubtful that it's me. That's so doubtful. And check real quick. I don't think so. Oh, it seemed to be good. Seemed to be good. Okay. Each player also gets their own individual map. The information that containing everything on the global map, as well as any still secret information that has yet to be revealed to the group. The players are responsible for keeping their own map up to date as the game progresses. As cartographers, the players need a clear legend in order to understand their own the information on it. So, nothing too confusing, unless they forget what their map says in the heat. Cool. Yeah. Tips and tricks. Kind of does it at the moment. Keep that in mind. Player starts drawing a room on the global map. Then they consult type of room tables, select die from the dice pool corresponding to the value they've selected. Player to his to their right, left, for the number of exits. Continuing counter clockwise, third and fourth players may select select two dice. There's the eight dice. Select four of the eight. Yeah, okay, we're cool. We're cool. Select two, select a die each from the room contents table. Lastly, active player selects the active player rolls a die divided by two. Divides result by two, rounding up. This will be the loot value for the room. These last two selections are kept secret. No, I guess they all be kept secret. Which is drawn on the indicated on the global map. All of the information selected by the players. Oh no, I guess the first. Yeah, they have to go. The two values number of exits and the loot value. Till an interaction triggers a reveal of those details. Continuing clockwise. There we go. Secret from the other players. Secret. And marked on personal maps. Okay. Play continues clockwise until each player has designed a room, created a new room. Then first player gets to move their character and take actions inside the rooms. God, this has been a slugfest. Just sitting and grinding. But hey, that's part of the writing process, right? Like, I've been talking about this recently with a few people, the idea of discipline, not motivation. Motivation is very fleeting. It leaves you at any given moment. Discipline is the ability to work regardless of motivation, get things done. So this is me being disciplined. Plugging through it. Which is fine. It's just I have a concrete deadline to get this done, and I'm gonna get it done. Or at least a early draft.
depending on what time I finish up, I may be able to get some sleep and then wake up early. Like, send it to a few people, get, like, hit the sack, and then wake up early in order to submit. But it depends. I feel like I'm getting fairly close to, but to where I'm supposed to be with this. So this is going to be combat. Actions. And four. We're gonna put character death in combat. No, Adrani, I just slugging away. Slugging away. Doing what I can. Actually, Johnny, just because I'm curious, and since you're here, do you know if Twitch counts mods towards the viewer count? Because every time I see it, it doesn't make any sense to me. Like, the numbers. So, just curious if you knew. Yes, you think they count, or you think they don't count? I am confused, but sure. Save the room. Play ends when character and their character is moved past one of the entrances to the room. Okay, weird. I don't understand, but sure. That math doesn't all. Whatevs. Probably pretty hard to keep track of a lot of that. Okay. Traps, enemies, combat doesn't need to be set for a second. Let's see. Damage and death. Blah, blah, blah. No, you know what? Because I'm actually cool with that. A, because it's kind of traditional to do it that way. Also, what I want to do is I also want to include
Did all that. So, so I also want to include stuff about items. So gear. And anything else that can be found in the room on the search table. Yeah, no, that's not a thing anymore. Room types, number of rooms, room content. Traps, enemies. Still haven't figured out what else would go in the room contents that would be worth it. I guess you could do special items or something, like maybe there's an extra chest which adds a an additional search the room, or maybe it's a guaranteed item or something like that. That's possible. Maybe there's like some sort of healing fountain or something. Something similar to that, where you could find like something that like you interact with that could be added to a room. So that's future plans. Of time. We shall see. I also gotta rewrite the forward at some point because it's a little hokey at the moment. Close. It's close to where I want it to be, but it's not quite there yet. Anyway, it's 9:05. So I'm gonna take another five minute break or so. And then when we come back, I'm going to... I'm going to make this a little bit of a longer episode today, mostly because I don't want to really slow my roll, and also because I don't have a ton planned for the outro to this week again. I'm going to change that. I think I've determined the level of outlining I want to do, because I was doing too much outlining, and I was getting stuck in kind of like, I have to cover this, oh my god, blah, blah, blah. But I think I need to make like a general scope of like header sort of thing, without like all the little content-y bits, so that I have a general idea of the scope of the episode and what I'm trying to, where I'd like to be, but not necessarily all the little detailed bits behind that. So I think for next week when we go back to the short story, I'm gonna do, but yeah, 5 minute break. I'll see you guys after.